Professor Francis Stoessel of the nonprofit Swiss Institute for the Promotion of Safety and Security asks,
is your process resistant towards maloperation? Is the cooling capacity sufficient to deal with the heat release rate of the reaction?
Predicting the worst-case scenario is critical in order to speed development and avoid catastrophe in production. In his talk, Avoiding Incidents at Scale-Up, Stoessel uses RC1 reaction calorimetry data to evaluate critical thermodynamic information.
The adiabatic temperature rise can easily be calculated by building the ratio between the heat of reaction and the heat capacity. Both values may be measured in a reaction calorimeter. So we also see that the temperature rise is proportional to the energy released and therefore may be used as a measure of the severity of an incident.
Using this understanding, chemists and engineers can predict how an emergency would unfold in the case of a cooling failure and redesign the process itself with safety in mind.
Using the RC1 data, we can assess the severity, the probability of occurrence of secondary reactions, the criticality class, and finding out what the weak points are to take measures against it.
So, how can you identify the criticality of a reaction and overcome weak points?
The cooling failure scenario and the criticality classes allow assessing the thermal risks linked to a process. The RC1 data allow to choose and design the required safety measures, rendering processes robust against maloperation.
Learn more about the 5 questions that must be answered before a chemical process is considered safe.
Visit mt.com/scaleup-webinar.